I am the vine, you are the branches, remain in me. You shall be fruitful, love for the world.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
Remain in me as I remain in you. Just as a branch cannot bear fruit on its own unless it remains on the vine, so neither can you unless you remain in me. I am the vine, you are the branches. Whoever remains in me and I in him will bear much fruit. Because without me, you can do nothing. Anyone who does not remain in me will be thrown out like a branch and wither. People will gather them and throw them into a fire, and they will be burned. If you remain in me and my words remain in you, ask for whatever you want, and it will be done for you. By this is my Father glorified, that you bear much fruit and become my disciples. My brothers and sisters, this is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
God is good, and so are we. Again, God is good, and so are we. That has been introduced in several of my homilies before, and I hope you can still remember the topic of my last homily. Anybody? I met this morning, the first person I talked to was Mariah, and she asked me, Father, are you going to say the homily today? I said, yes. Do you remember what you're supposed to continue with your last homily? And I said, I don't know. What was it about? Because the title of my homily was Forgive and Forget. So, I just can't remember. Anyway, this will be the continuation of our conversation and reflection on our idea of or concept of forgetting, because when we talk about forgiveness, necessarily in our context of faith, we talk about God forgiving us. It's not us forgiving God. And also, on the context of God, His forgiveness is His forgetfulness. Because for God, everything is present. It's in the now. That's why when Jesus was in the was nailed to the cross, one of His seven last words was, Father, forgive them, for they do not know what they are doing. He was actually in the presence of a man, a thief, a criminal, who is apologetic and wanted to be forgiven, wanted to be in paradise with Jesus. And the presence of that man is the reaction of Jesus in this context of the situation. God is always present in our midst, in our lives. He's always with us. And we can also remember, I hope, last Sunday, our Bishop Arturo is now a elected bishop, but not consecrated yet. He had a wonderful homily and sharing for us on what Christ said, I am the good shepherd. And from that, we also reflected with him our connection, our relationship with our dear Bishop Peter here, because he has always been part of our lives. And I know that he's always praying for us and leading us all to Jesus. And so, my dear friends, that topic or that statement of Christ, I am the good shepherd, reminds us again of what we have in the gospel today. I am the vine, you are the branches. And there are several I am statements of Christ in the Gospel of John, mostly in the Gospel of John. Say, for example, we heard Jesus saying, I am the bread of life. I am the gate. I am the door to eternal life. I am the light of the world. What else? Doris, do you remember? Can you add something to that I am statement of Christ?
I am the way, the truth, and the life.
I am the way, the truth, and the life. How about you, Marido?
I am the resurrection and the life.
Good. You remember that. So we have actually seven statements, including what we have today. And don't worry, I won't be asking anybody from you. The question and answer were planted on Doris and Mario. Just to bring you to the situation why we need to be focusing on the I am statement of Christ. That's a very important thing, because when he said, I am the vine and you are the branches, he is talking about our connectivity, our spiritual connectivity with Christ and with each other. We can also be in our own lives as parents or grandparents, the vine of the family. And there are several branches, the children, the grandchildren, the grand-grand. So we understand and we know how it feels to be in relationship, to be in responsibility. In our church, for example, the community in St. Matthew, we know that Bishop Peter is our vine associated with our own relationship here in the community, in our faith community. But also, among us, we have also some vine leaders, because we have priests and deacons and lay ministers in our community. With this, we know how to be interconnected with each other. It's very important to be connected to one another. That is in the context of our faith and spirituality, summons us to be always conscious of that connection and relationship with one another. And also this brings us to the idea that in the lifetime of Christ, his statements, his personal I am statements have been sources of reflection. They have been given to us in order that we will know how to bring this actively in our lives. For example, the vine and the branches. I know some of you are good planters. You know how to plant flowers, plant fruit trees. If you go to the house of Father Ben and Mario, you will see a lot of fruit trees. And you are always welcome, with their permission, of course. What I mean is, they are always giving and giving, from the lemons to the persimmons, etc. And I know you have your own plants and flowers at home. And you know how to take care of them. You know how to prune things from the plant or trees so that they will bear more fruit. So our relationship with God is not only a connection as branches, but that we have to be also bearing fruits. It's not just enough to be a Christian, that I am a Christian and a Catholic and connected to this community of faith. I'm done. No. We are always being challenged to be active and to be fruitful, to bear fruit. If I ask the same question with our guest priest here, Father Armand from Bacolod, what is he connected with in his community in the Philippines? How is he directly associated with the people in his parish church? Surely he would answer, he's knowing him, because we have been together in the Philippines, in Bacolod before, and I know a lot of good things about him, and also some not good things about him, but if you are interested, I cannot say it here, but text me, because texting, iPad, iPhone, these are connections that we use today. Facebook, what else? Twitter, everything. We connect with each other. And Father Armand is connected with this. I know him. He is connected with this community because he wanted to be realistic and active and fruitful in his priesthood. Why? Because I know him to be connected with the poor, the deprived, the oppressed, and the exploited people. in his parish, in his province. Because we know the Philippines is still a corrupt, under a corrupt government. There are a lot of things that affected the poor. When they say poor, these are not just ordinary poor. These are exploited people. And I know Father Arman is very connected with these people. When we visited Bacolod in 2016 with Bishop Peter, Father Arman introduced us to some of his lay leaders organization in the parish. These are the orphan poor organization. And Bishop Peter and the priest with me, Father Ben, Father Arturo, Father Julian, and their wives, we extended kind of contribution and help for the continuing involvement of Father Arman to these people in Bacolod. So my dear friends, connectivity is a very important part of our being a Christian, of being branches to the Lord, branches to our community. And as long as we know how to conduct ourselves in the pattern of the Gospel of John, that speaks to us about the vine and the branches, we know that we live in accordance of the statutes that has been challenged to us in the first reading and also in the second reading. The command of God to be faithful, connected with Him. We live in an age when there's so much unprecedented connectedness because of the advancement of technology. And in the midst of the media communication, we have experience instant connection with people that we love, we like, even though they are far from us. It's easy to interconnect with them. But how ironic it is to think that sometimes we are also disconnected with one another. That is an important realization of our media technology, but better than this is our connection with God. Let us not disconnect ourselves with the Lord. Let us not disconnect ourselves with our faith community. Let us not disconnect ourselves in our family, in our siblings, in our bigger community at large, because once we are always conscious of that, then we can all say together, God is good. God is good. Amen.
Remain in me, you shall be fruitful, love for the world.